there's just a fate we can't deny. In the war between his veins and his mind, and Joe got sick from Sammy's lies. Two lovers waiting to die.
So we just try to be ourselves and don't, you know, we use machines as much as other people use machines on occasion, depending if we feel like it. You know, I'm not going to base my life on, you know, a Giorgio Moroder, you know, disco beat from 78 and turn that into my career. Some of these bands, their first single is what winds up on their third record. You know, they never change.
And that wouldn't be much fun.
And that's not fun.
It's no fun to go out and play that.
You can't tell me that the Happy Mondays in the farm are having any fun playing their record on stage. That's what they're doing.
They're not doing it, they're just playing the record.
Yeah. Okay, boss. Living under the gun. Yeah. mordida. It's time to pay your toll. Yeah, they call me La Mordida. It's time to pay your toll. Yeah, catch me now or later. I'll crawl back in your
old music, you know. I mean, I like Howlin' Wolf, and I like George Jones, and you know.
Thank you. There's 16 kids and 16 ways. The federale said it was one big mistake. They're running dope, we had to shoot. Down here there's nothing like it.
Grateful Dead going out there, they probably average more per gig than any band. They're averaging like 65,000 in attendance. And they're up there playing like Mona and stuff, you know, like playing Bo Diddley songs and Dylan songs. And a band like the Happy Mondays, we might do an American tour of large discos, or a band like Jesus Jones, or, you know, who's the band from LA that's Lollapalooza guys? Jane's Addiction. Yeah. I don't know, you know. I mean, I figure we probably got as much in common with Guns N' Roses as we do any of those bands, you know. I mean, when I listen to Guns N' Roses, I can hear the changes and stuff. You know, they're a rock band.
Driving around in circles day after day, week after week.
Son of the gotta go in.
Get a job at the local Piggly Wiggly, selling beer to creeps all day. Well, nothing's changed in Memphis anyway. And I'm a zombie. I'm a zombie.
Yeah.
It's become part of our culture, you know. But I don't know if that's in danger of becoming extinct. I don't think that REM could ever replace that. Because what they're doing is, it has no fundamental basis. It's so disposable and insipid and shallow, and he's not actually saying anything. He's saying things.
I mean, 20 years from now,
there's nothing concrete in the imagery, and there's nothing you can really reach out and grab. It's just sort of like a, really easily digestible fast food cheeseburger. You know, it's real soft and it goes down easy. You know, I mean, I don't think there's anything. I don't think that it's gonna be anything that anything's based on. You know,
20 years from now, their kids are still gonna be playing Chuck Berry songs, and they're still gonna go out and pick up a Howlin' Wolf CD and go, how many more years is this going on? And they're going to just say, what the hell is that? That is beautiful. They're not going to put on REM and say, you know, this is what I'm going to base my new band on, even though there's a million REMs out there. And same with you, too. They're kind of, you're talking about the same problem there. You're talking about two bands that keep doing their first single over and over again, who are basically singing lyrics about be happy about yourself, you know, find God in your own life because you are God, basically. You know, what a lot of this, it's new age preaching, it's new age speak, and they ought to be in the new age section of the record store. You know, I would rather have just Green on Red over the side with Dr. John and you know, the Replacements or whatever, and just keep, you know, have a whole other section for all this current pop music.
Joe!
So country music in that tradition is pretty healthy, really. It's gone through a lot of phases, but it's pretty healthy.
But it's green and red country music?
Sure.
Well, we're using the same thing.
And blues. You just put a backbeat to it. See, out of that horrible tradition of Irish folk music coming to America and having to be poverty-stricken coal miners, that and African slavery, terrible, another terrible, horrible history. You got our rock and roll, you know. That's all it is. Country blues with a backbeat. It sounds so simple, but God, it's like a freak thing to be playing that nowadays. People go, just what the hell are you doing?
It sounds so-
fool for falling in.
my baby dragged it out of the pouring rain. When I die, you'll hear me cry out.
See you later.